Happy morning, children. Welcome back. This is your English online class for standard 5. All of you take your course book. The lesson name is Grandpa's Tree by Ruth Harrigan. In this lesson, you have conjunctions in page number 114. All of you open to page number 114. 114. Do you see this in page number 114, all of you? Linking words. Can you see? Right. So, linking words are nothing but conjunctions, which you have learned in class 1, 2, 3, 4 also. Now you are learning in class 5. You will learn this even when you go to 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right. Okay. It's good. It goes on and on. See now. Linking words, the word linking words means nothing but conjunctions. They just join two words or two sentences or two small phrases. Any word, anything, they join. Can you see these words given in your textbook? There is a tabular column like this. Linking words are given in one side. The other side, where do we use them? The condition is given. Watch carefully, children. Let's check the first one. Because, as, since. These three linking words are used when you are in a position to give some reason. And that's why it is given here to state reason. Right? I missed the class because I was sick. As I was sick, I missed the class. Since I was sick, I missed the class. Do you understand? So, this shows the reason. You give reason for not doing something. Clear? Right. So, the next one is, so, therefore. Where do we use so and therefore? To explain effect. The outcome. You understand? We'll take the same sentence. No, we'll make another sentence. It rained heavily, so the people left the place. What was the outcome of the rain? Yeah, people left the place. We are using so. It rained so heavily and it flooded, so people left the place, evacuated from the place. Same you can use for therefore also. It rained so heavily and the area was flooded, therefore the people left the place. Is it easy? Yes. Now, children, this is very easy actually, because this is not new for you. This chapter is not new for you. We have learnt a lot even in class 5 itself in our IEO chapter. Right? In detail we learnt. So, this is in your textbook. So, we are just revising one more time. Now, let's see the next one. If, unless, otherwise. They say we have to use if, unless, otherwise to state the condition. See, for example, if you work hard, you will attain success. You're giving a condition. Work hard. That is the condition here. Unless you work hard, you will never attain success. Here also you give a condition. Do you understand? You have to work hard. Otherwise, you will not attain success. Are you clear, children? Yes. See, you have to listen to this video and then you have to make your own sentences. Clear? So, that shows that you have understood. Clear? After listening to this page, you start writing your own sentences in your homework notebook or rough notebook. You try. If you want, you can play back and then watch how I explain here. And then you start writing your own sentences. Clear, children? Good. Next one is in order to. This is one conjunction, in order to. So that we have to use these two, in order to and so that, to show and to state the purpose. Clear? See, in order to reach the goal, I got up early in the morning. Why did you get up early in the morning? In order to reach the goal. That is the purpose. I got up early in the morning so that I could reach the success, or so that I could reach the goal. Am I right? Yeah. So now you are going to make sentences on your own. Okay. Let's move on to the next one. Then, later, finally, afterwards, all these conjunctions, all these linking words are used to introduce a sequence. Sequence is nothing but when you speak something without any break, right? You have to link the second sentence with the first sentence. That is the second statement of your speech with the previous statement. So for that, you will use then, later, finally, afterwards. Clear? Let's see some examples, okay? I walked very fast. I just rushed really, and then I got into the bus. Clear? Now later, let's make some sentence, a sentence with later. We all got into the bus. The driver was ready to start the bus. We were so happy. Finally, I'm using finally. Finally, the driver started the bus. Later, we started singing songs. See how I'm using all these words. We reached the destination. We enjoyed. We came back to school. Afterwards, we started writing an essay on our trip. See how I am using all these words in a small paragraph. It's easy, right? You can make. Let's move on to the next one. But, yet, in spite of, despite, however, on the other hand, all these conjunctions, all these linking words show contrast. Contrast is nothing but just opposite of that. Clear? Let's make some examples using the linking words here in the last box. But, yet, in spite of, despite, however, on the other hand, to show contrast. Now listen, watch carefully. I rushed to the railway station, but I missed the train. See, I rushed to the railway station, but I missed the train. I rushed, but that shows contrast. Opposite of that. I rushed and I got into the train is perfect, but you missed. So, this shows contrast. I waited for a long time in the railway station, yet the next train did not come. You understand? Somehow I managed and reached the office. In spite of my struggle, the manager scolded me. Despite my struggle, my higher authority scolded me. I felt bad. However, I relaxed. I started doing my work. higher authority called me for something. I was so nervous and went inside his room. I stood in front of him, expecting hard words from my higher official. On the other hand, he appreciated me for my previous day's work. Just a very, very small incident. See, I have used all these linking words in small paragraph, showing contrast. I hope you are all clear now, children, right? Let's see some sentences with but and yet. Look at the screen. It's not there in your textbook. Look at the screen. The weather was cold, dash bright and sunny. The weather was cold, yet bright and sunny. Her advice seems strange, yet I believe she's right. It shows even though. Right? The weather was cold, even though it was bright and sunny. So we are using yet. Her advice seems strange, very weird advice. Even though I believe she is right. But I believe she is right. Yet I believe she is right. Can you see how I am using different words of conjunctions here? I am amazed that you haven't told him anything yet. The meaning here is like this. I am amazed that you haven't told him anything till this time. That's the meaning of this yet here. I'm amazed that you haven't told him anything yet. I didn't have my breakfast yet. Till this time, I didn't have my breakfast. Clear now? Yes. He hasn't yet decided if he wants to come or not. He hasn't yet decided. Till this time, he has not decided whether he has to come or not for the party or for the celebration or for the program. I haven't decided yet. I haven't yet decided if I had to go for the movie. Frame sentences on your own now. Come on. Now let's see some sentences using in spite of and despite. Both has the same meaning, children. Look here, in spite of the fact that he worked very hard, he didn't pass the exam. I'll repeat, join with me. In spite of the fact that he worked very hard, he didn't pass the exam. I'm using instead of in spite of, we'll use despite. Despite the fact that he worked very hard, he didn't pass the exam. It has the same meaning. Can you see? Here I've used only in spite of the fact. See here, despite the fact. Yes. Even though he worked very hard, he didn't pass the exam. That's the actual meaning. Right? Though he has put all his effort, he didn't pass the exam. It's the meaning of this. Look here. In spite of the law, people continue to use mobile phones while driving. Same I'm using here. I'll just remove this in spite of using despite. Despite the law. People continue to use mobile phones while driving. In spite of my mother's scolding, I deny to drink milk. Despite my mother's scolding, I deny to drink milk. Now you can make sentences. Come on, smarts, you're all. Now let's see some sentences using the conjunction however. The first sentence goes like this. I will assist however I can. I will assist my friend. I will assist you however I can in all possible ways. What best I could do, I will do. If your friend is in a very bad situation and he or she asks for help, you say this. I will assist you however I can. What best I can, I will do. The engineers said the bridge was not safe. However, no one wanted to risk crossing it. Listen carefully, understand. The engineer said the bridge was now safe. It is now safe. We have did some modulation in the building. Sorry, in the bridge. We have done some renovation. It is very safe and strong. This is the announcement by the engineers. But no one wanted to risk crossing it. However, even though no one wanted to risk crossing it. Clear now? Next one. Next sentence using however. Decorate it however you like. However you like. It's your choice. Got the meaning? Yes. However, we must get to work. It is really very hard nowadays. However, we must get to work. We can't sit at home idle. However, we must get to work. The situation is very bad. We are unable to meet in school. We are unable to meet in the real classroom. However, we must study. We must get to work. Now you make sentences. Now let's see about on the other hand. On the other hand is a conjunction. It is used to compare two situations or two people and to show that there is an important difference between them. If you want to show some difference between two situations or two people, we will use this on the other hand. You remember, just to recall, sometime back only I gave you one example. I said, I was so nervous and I stood in front of my higher authority, expecting hard words from my higher authority. On the other hand, he appreciated me. See the situations, see how it is compared. You see the difference, you feel the difference there. Yes, that's all. So now here are some sentences using on the other hand. Let's see, look at the screen, read along with me. It is a great building. On the other hand, a lot of animals lost their home by building it. You appreciate in the beginning. Look at the sentence, watch carefully. You appreciate the building. And you say, it is a great building. Wow, it's so beautiful. Immediately you say, on the other hand, a lot of animals lost their home by building it. That means the trees and plants, a forest structure has been demolished to build that building. So you mention on the other hand. You say the difference. It is a great building. On the other hand, lots of animals lost their home by building it. Clear? Right. Next one. I want to go to the party. On the other hand, I must be studying. Right? So this is kind of feeling where you show the difference. I want to help my mother. On the other hand, I want to complete my work. Now you make sentences, children. Shall we do some exercise? Watch. Look at the screen. A conjunction is a word that joins parts of a sentence, phrases, or other words together. Let's see the first one. We went to the stadium and enjoyed the cricket match. Now check. Where is the conjunction? Which is the conjunction here? Very good. You all got the answer. Good. And second one. Do you want an ice cream or chocolate? Where is the conjunction here? Right. You're absolutely right. Or third one. There are friends, but they didn't get a chance to play together. They are friends, but they didn't get a chance to play together. Where is the conjunction here? Amazing. But. Very good, children. Now you are going to use conjunctions in these sentences. Listen carefully, understand the situation, then only you can use the conjunction. Alex plays well, dash, he is selected to play the match. Alex plays well. You are giving some reason. So, Alex plays well, so he is selected to play the match. Good. Next one. Dash, he was sick. I went to see him. Dash, he was sick. Got it? When he was sick, I went to see him. Good. Now let's move on to the next one. Dash, you walk fast, you will catch the train. Dash, you walk fast, you will catch the train. This shows some condition. Very good, children. If you walk fast, you will catch the train. Alright, children. Now you have to play back the video and watch conjunctions.